Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And make sure you hit that like button because we're back here with some more Redskins franchise here on the channel. And we are looking at sliders this week. So what's funny about the sliders is that, you know, the gameplay is actually really good out of the gate. I haven't needed to change any sliders up to this point, but I do have a good sample size of games where I can make changes. So one thing I did want to make changes to, as far as player skill, fumbling needs to go down just a little bit. I've found that, you know, I fumbled at least once a game and sometimes at least twice a game. So I think the fumbles are a little bit too high, so I bumped that down to 5. I think everything else with the player skills are all right, the user sliders. But looking at the computer sliders, I decided to move up run blocking because stopping the run has just been entirely too easy. And you know what? Even trying to get sacks has been pretty much non-existent. I haven't got any sacks with any of my linebackers or defensive linemen. I always had to just send a free man in. It was either a user sack or the quarterback just rolled out and nobody was open. So I might want to make adjustments to the pass blocking for the user or for the computer. But then, you know, I don't really like to give myself an advantage like that. So if I were to do that, I would want to decrease something of the user skill. So just looking strictly at the NFC East and the quarterbacks here, you can see Carson Wentz is on top of the world right now. 8 touchdowns, 1 interception, already 1,000 yards. And we're in week 5. We did have a bye week, so Alex Smith did get rest. So he actually got hurt right at the right time. Comes off a bye week, so he's going to be ready to go. Eli Manning, actually, 4 touchdowns and 6 picks. I mean, he's not having a great season. Dak Prescott either, 2 touchdowns, 2 picks. And then Kevin Hogan's actually 4th in the division in passing ahead of Alex Smith. So that's a weird sighting there, but hey, it happens. So looking at who's leading our division in rush yards, Ezekiel Elliott, Jay Ajayi, not too far behind. They only have 2 touchdowns apiece. I'm kind of surprised to see Darren Sproles up here with 3 touchdowns. So he's actually leading the conference in touchdowns. So looking at receiver here, no surprise here, the Eagles receivers and tight ends leading the division. What, Sterling Shepard is actually 3rd. And I'm actually surprised by that because, you know, where is Odell Beckham? I do not see Odell Beckham on here. There he is. He's actually down here with 146 yards, 14 receptions. So let's just look at the leader in touchdowns. And then Alshon Jeffrey has 5. So, I mean, that's pretty surprising. I can't lie. That's pretty surprising. Let's look around the league to see who's leading the NFL now. So it looks like Alshon Jeffrey is leading the NFL in touchdowns. Stephon Diggs is right behind him, a Golden Tate, and Kendall Wright. I mean, Kendall Wright for the Vikings. I never thought that he would be one of the guys leading the NFL in touchdowns. But then looking at yards, Jarvis Landry is leading. Julio Jones, no surprise. And Nunua, that's actually no surprise because Nunua, if you follow the Jets, this guy is actually pretty talented. I'm not surprised to see him up there. Randall Cobb, you know he's got Aaron Rodgers, so that's an advantage. And then behind him, Marquise Lee and Gronkowski. Let's look at the passing leaders in the NFL. Look at this. Blake Bortles is actually leading in yards. I cannot believe it. And in touchdowns. It might be in touchdowns too. Let's just see. Yup, he's leading in touchdowns. Look at Deshaun Watson though. Man, 11 touchdowns, no interceptions. That man is just killing this year. But I mean, I'm so surprised to see Blake Bortles. I mean, he might be the early favorite for MVP. I mean, that's kind of crazy. So let's just look at the standings here in the NFC East. We did just come off the bye week, so we only played 3 games. But let's just look at the NFC East. We'll check out the rest of the NFL once we get kind of towards halfway through the schedule. Not a big sample size here, but the Eagles are 4-0. They are killing right now. We are 2-1. The Cowboys are 2-2. And then the Giants are 0-4. So we are going up against who else? The New Orleans Saints. So we are going to go up against Drew Brees. And one guy I want to point out coming into this game that I've been training with a lot more now, Monte Nicholson. I mean, this guy is just killing for me. If I go over to him, he's only 75 overall, but he's 22 years old. He's got a lot of room to develop. He is a zone guy. He does fit our scheme pretty well, and he's 92 speed, 77 zone, which is actually really, really good. I do want to get his tackling up, but I like the potential out of him. And then one other guy I do want to note here, and I do want to develop, is Fabian Moreau. So Fabian Moreau actually doesn't get on the field too much. He's been on the field a little bit because guys have been hurt, but I need to take advantage of that speed. 94 speed, 93 acceleration. He's going to keep up with the fastest guys in the league, and it's only his second year in the league from UCLA, so I want to see what he can do when he gets on the field. So I do plan on running the ball, well, probably a little bit more, I mean, to be honest, because Darius Geis, he does have an upgrade here, so let's actually upgrade him. You see he has good speed, 89 speed, 91 carry, 92 truck. I mean, should I just upgrade his trucking to make him just an amazing power back? I think I might do it, because right now the scheme fit is actually elusive back. So you know what, let me just upgrade elusive back, because I want to see how far I can progress him. He does go up to 80 overall as a rookie. Let's see what he gets now. Okay, plus one speed, good job there. Plus three spin move and plus one agility. So he's up to 90 speed now. So I mean, he's gonna be getting the ball quite a bit. I mean, more than he already should be getting right now, but I mean, look at it. I mean, he's a monster. So let's get him involved. Let's let him have a good game here. So we are going up against the Saints. And are we at home here? I think nope, we're on the road. So we are going into the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. So let's get into this action. Let's get it. Let's go. So up until last season, the Saints were kind of known as just this offensive minded team with no defense, and since they got a defense last year, I mean, now they are a force. I would watch out for them this season. The Saints might do it, and remember, they were so close last season, and I actually thought that was like the Saints year. When I saw them in the playoffs, I'm like, oh, this might be Drew Brees' year to get back on top. And I kind of feel bad for the guy. He's like Aaron Rodgers. I mean, the Packers haven't surrounded Rodgers with any defense. Neither have the Saints, but the Saints finally got one last season. So here we go underway. And here is Ted Ginn Jr. back to receive the kick, and he's going to return it to about the 23-yard line. So here is Drew Brees coming out onto the field, and he's Mr. New Orleans for sure. Reporters have always debated whether he might leave or not, but nah, I think he's going to be a Saint for life. So here is Drew Brees to start this game out from the shotgun, finding Mike Thomas there for the 9-yard reception. So on a second and one, here he is under center this time, giving it to Mark Ingram. And look at Mark Ingram. He has a huge hole, and he's going to break away, get past the 50, closer to 20 to the 10, and he's going to be tackled at the 6-yard line. So what a way to start this game out for Mark Ingram, a 60-yard carry. So on a first and goal here, Alvin Kamara is spinning his way into the end zone. But look, there's a flag on the play, so we do get helped out because of the flag. So now facing a second and goal a couple plays later from about the 12-yard line. Here is Drew Brees throwing the ball up for grabs, and look who's there. Zach Brown gets the interception. So we get lucked out. We give up a 60-yard run. We give up another touchdown. And then all of a sudden, we get a pick. So we at least play some great defense. Our defense continues to ball out. And here is Darius Geis back out on offense. Like I said, I want to get him going early on and often in this game. So here is Alex Smith under center. This time throwing to Jamison Crowder, taking a big hit over the middle. So now on a first and 10, here is Darius Geis getting the ball up the middle. Haven't found a crease yet, but it's gonna eventually get there. So now on a third and 9 here, here's Alex Smith trying to throw across the middle, but that one is going to be deflected. Trying to get the ball to Paul Richardson on that one. But we have some bad news after that first drive. Jonathan Allen, he fractures his foot. So, I mean, another injury. Add him to the list of injuries. And that's going to suck, because now We got to play without one of our best young defensive ends. So now here comes Drew Brees back on the offense, handing the ball to Kamara on that one. And he does get around the tackle, picks up the first down, getting close to about the 50-yard line. So here is Drew Brees under center this time, handing it off one more time to Kamara. And Kamara does get stopped that time by DJ Swearinger. So now on a 3rd and 4, here he is at the 46-yard line, throwing to the outside, and Kamara does barely get the first down. So Kamara's been touching the ball quite a bit in this game early on. So now here is Drew Brees on a 1st and 10, but this time Mark Ingram is not going to bust out a long run on this one. Going to get stopped by Zach Brown. So now facing a 3rd and 4 here. Here is Drew Brees running out to the left, to the right. And look at this deflection. Josh Hill catches that ball off of the deflection, but loses ground and does not pick up the first down. So the Saints do have to kick the long field goal, and that one is going to be good. So now back out on our next drive. Here is Alex Smith on a 5-wide from the shotgun. Gonna find Chris Thompson open on the drag route, and he's gonna make it to the 37-yard line. So now 30 seconds left here in this first quarter. A play fake to Thompson that time, and he's gonna try one deep, and Richardson can't come up with that one. Marshawn Lattimore on the coverage on that one. So now on a 3rd and 9 here from the shotgun, once again throwing the ball deep, and look who's there. Paul Richardson one more time. And man, I love me some Paul Richardson. I'm starting to figure out how to use him, and I'm liking it so far. I like what I see from him, and he's gonna be a pretty good weapon as Alex Smith does move the chains on the next throw, getting inside the 10-yard line, but on a 2nd and goal, trying to give it to Darius Geis, but Geis is stuffed there at the line of scrimmage. So now on a 3rd and goal here, 2-back set here from the shotgun, but he's going to get swallowed up by Cam Jordan, and that's going to be the first sack of the game for the star defensive end. But we do settle for the field goal, make this a 3-3 game here in the second quarter. So here's Drew Brees back out on offense, but we're sending the blitz on a play fake, and Orlando Scandrick gets in from the slot blitz. And now that we get him down to a 3rd and 14, as Kamara gets the screen pass, but he's not going anywhere on that one. Nice tackle that time by the rookie, Tim Settle. So now we get the ball back after the punt as Darius Geis, or Chris Thompson, gets the handoff, and he gets pretty much pummeled on that one. So now on a 3rd and 3 here, Alex Smith from under center, gonna drop back to pass here, find an open man, but Richardson can't make a move and get upfield, and he gets tackled before the first down. So we have to punt the ball back to New Orleans, 3-3 in this game. Nice defensive game as both defenses are playing pretty well. So Drew Brees trying to get a first down that time. The receiver can't stay in bounds and get some more yards. But on a 3rd and 5, here is, so close. Brandon Coleman on that one gets open for the first down. So now here is Alvin Kamara trying to get some yards, but he can't do anything there. So now on a 2nd and 12, here's Kamara one more time. Almost gets stopped in the backfield, but breaks a tackle and does get close to the first down marker. So now facing a 3rd and 2, here's Kamara one more time, but look who's there. I mean, Vigil is just killing this season. He's off to a hot start, a guy that I didn't expect to see anything from, and he's just balling out. So now we have 3 minutes left in this half as Chris Thompson gets the handoff to the outside from the pistol formation, and he picks up a first down. So now on a play fake here, Alex Smith, good protection here, and he's going to find Jamison Crowder now past the 50-yard line. So now we're in business. Almost 2 minutes left in this half, and here is Jordan Reed getting open, and he's moving the chains for a first down. So now under 2 minutes left, here's a play fake once again, and we've been using this play fake quite a bit in this game, and it's been working as Alex Smith scrambles out and picks up 16 yards. So now on a 2nd and 6, a minute left in this half, here is Chris Thompson getting up the middle, and he's going to almost get the first on that one, but we do eventually convert. So now on a 1st and goal here from the 6-yard line, Chris Thompson gets another handoff, And he has 6 rushes for 31 yards up to this point. A pretty good half from him. So now on a 3rd and goal, here's a pitch play. And Chris Thompson is going to get in on this one as we are taking the 10-3 lead going into halftime. And let's just look around the league as we see the Giants actually won against the Panthers 38-20. We also see the Cowboys beat the Texans 24-20. And then the Eagles end up winning versus the Vikings 21-10. So all 3 of the teams in our division end up winning this week, as this is actually prime time. So now on a 2nd and 8 to start this half, here's Alex Smith throwing across the field, kind of a cardinal sin, but he was open and he misses the receiver. So now on a 3rd and 8, here's Alex Smith throwing the ball deep, but look who's there, Paul Richardson. Like I said, I'm figuring out how to use Paul Richardson. He's a guy that can move all over. He can play in the slot. He can play on the outside. I just like what I see from him, and he moves the chains. So now we are past the 50 on the other side into field goal range, and here on a 1st and 10, here's Chris Thompson getting a draw play. And these draw plays are really nice on this game. I love them, as Chris Thompson picks up a nice 10-yard gain. So now on a 1st and 10 here inside of the red zone now, Alex Smith gonna drop back and get strip sacked on that one by, I believe that was Cliff Averill, and that is gonna be a loss of 16 yards. So now on a 3rd and 26, just trying to get some yardage back to get back into field goal range, and we do just that, getting the ball out to Brian Quick. So we do have to settle for the field goal, and that one is gonna be good, but we do take the 13-3 lead here in the third quarter. So now here comes Drew Brees back out on offense, throwing the ball across the middle. I didn't expect him to throw that, but Josh Hill does come up with that reception that time. So now on a 1st and 15, after a false start call, here he is finding Cam Meredith on the outside, and look at him, Lando Scandrick just gets burnt on the out route and just loses track of his man, and he had no help over the top. And Cameron Meredith takes it all the way to the house. So right when we, you know, think we have a comfortable lead, we're stopping Drew Brees, they get a touchdown. So now here comes Samaje Perine back out on offense, and he gets a nice 10-yard gain. Doesn't get in much, but that's a good way to get some playing time by fighting for yardage like that, as we do find another receiver for a 1st down. Alex Smith, nice throw that time. So now under center on the play fake, here is Alex Smith rolling out to the right, gonna throw to the right side, and Jordan Reed is going to be there for the catch on the sideline, as we are moving the chains pretty nicely in this game, just not putting up many points. But on a 3rd and 8, here's some more pressure, and Marcus Davenport, the rookie defensive end who they traded for, gets the best of Trent Williams on that one, and he comes up with the sack. So now on the ensuing punt here, trying to pin them back inside the 5, but look at this, the Saints get to it, and that is a blocked punt. So now the Saints are set up with great field position on this next drive, close to about the 30-35 yard line. So now on a 3rd and 7 here, here's Drew Brees throwing to the outside, and Kamara is just a monster. He is hard to tackle. Trust me, when you play the Saints, he's hard to tackle. So now they're facing a 2nd and 4 here, throwing to the outside, but Hill can't stay in bounds, and he does have to force another 3rd down. So 3rd and 1 on this one, but this time DJ Swearinger is coming up in the box and making the tackle on Kamara, and we do force them to settle for the field goal. So the Saints come all the way back, down 10 points, tie this game up at 13 apiece. But back on our offense, it's not getting much better for our offensive line, as Sheldon Rankins gets in for the sack. So now facing a 3rd and 18. Here's Alex Smith finding some more pressure, and Cliff Averill gets in for another sack. So this defensive line, I mean, they are just tearing us up. And maybe that draft pick of Marcus Davenport, remember, they traded 2 first rounds pretty much to get him. I mean, they traded this year's first round, so they traded back, or they traded up, The Packers traded back, but the Packers also got a first round next year to get Marcus Davenport. So maybe getting these extra defensive ends, these extra pass rushers, is going to pay off, because right now they are killing us as Drew Brees throws to Josh Hill over the middle. And a wrong dive on that one. Dives to the wrong side. Guesses wrong. And that is going to be a touchdown for New Orleans. So now up 7 points here. And some more pressure. Cliff Avril in for his third sack of the game. And that's 6 sacks total here for the Saints so far. So now we're on to the fourth quarter here. But Alex Smith finding an open Paul Richardson. And he's pretty much the only receiver we're really hearing from in this game, as Jordan Reed and Paul Richardson are pretty much doing all of the work here. And here's Chris Thompson coming out of the backfield, and he's getting to the outside on a 3rd-and-3, moving the chains. So let's get on the board here. So now inside the 30-yard line, here's Alex Smith from the shotgun trying to roll out left, and he does pick up maybe 2 yards on that. So now on a 3rd-and-5 here, Alex Smith giving the calls at the line of scrimmage, and this one's going to be tipped at the line. Wide open was Josh Doctson on that, so we do have to go for it and at least keep this drive alive. And Jordan Reed cannot hold on to it as he takes a big hit over the middle. And Drew Brees, you see, he's been doing great in the second half. He's been carving us. And here he continues that as Cameron Meredith gets the reception over the middle, and Drew Brees is moving the ball nicely as he's now under center on a 1st-and-10. That looked like a play fake, but look at Kerrigan. He doesn't fall for it, and he strips the ball from behind on Kamara, and just the turnover we needed by Ryan Kerrigan. He hasn't done anything in the pass rush, no sacks. But he's been stopping the run like no other, so he gives us new life. But back out on the field is Alex Smith fumbling the ball right back, and that's unfortunate. This pass rush is just too much for our offensive line. Remember, Trent Williams is our best left tackle, but look, number 72 is in right now at left tackle. Trent Williams must have got hurt on one of these plays, and you can just tell this pass rush is just now taking advantage without our Pro Bowl, all-pro left tackle, as Alvin Kamara picks up the first down on that play here. So now here is Drew Brees and the Saints trying to waste some time here, but we're sending the blitz, and who else? Zach Vigil gets in for the sack. So now facing a 3rd-and-15, here is Drew Brees handing it off to Kamara, and Kamara is going to get stopped before the first down marker, but that's going to still be in field goal range, and they are going to kick this field goal and make it a 2-score lead. So now here's Washington back out onto the field. We do have one timeout left here, but we need to move this ball, score quickly, and get an onside kick to even stay in this game. So now here's Alex Smith back from the shotgun. Here he is, some more pressure. He feels it, so he does scramble. He gets out of there, and he does get another first down on the scramble. So now on a 2nd-and-10 here from the shotgun, this pass rush is just right there. But luckily he does get the pass away, gets it to Jamison Crowder as we get to about the 25-yard line. So now on a 1st-and-10 here, here's Alex Smith rolling out to the right but trying to throw the ball away. But another sack. That is 9 sacks here for the New Orleans Saints. And they are just abusing our offensive line as we felt the pressure on that one and we got rid of it. And look what happens. If we didn't get rid of it there, that would have been a sack. And we turn the ball over and New Orleans takes care of business at home. And the Redskins, I mean, that was just poor, poor, poor offensive line play. And we definitely need to get better there. Check up on Trent Williams. I don't know the extent of his injury or what's going on with him, but we'll have to find out next episode, as Chris Thompson actually has a decent game running the ball and receiving the ball. Paul Richardson, we're starting to figure it out with him. He goes over 100 yards, 110 yards in this game. But, I mean, we just could not stop that pass rush. Our blocking just wasn't on, as, I mean, a lot of things kind of went right on defense. We stopped a lot of big plays. Zach Vigil had a good game. Zach Brown had a good game. Scandrick had a good game. We just need to put it all together, offense and defense. And it starts up front with our line. I mean, both of our lines are struggling. Our defensive line isn't getting any sacks. Our offensive line has given up way too many sacks. So, I mean, that's been kind of the story of this year so far. So hit subscribe, hit that like button, because next week we're going up against another NFC South team, Cam Newton and the Panthers. So you don't want to miss that. So stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.